الحمد لله رب العالمين، إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وحبيبه الخاتم لما سبق والفاتح لمن غلق وناصر الحق بالحق. فصلوات ربي وتسليماته عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله. إخوتي وأخواتي، نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى في هذا اليوم الكريم، وهو يوم الجمعة، وفي هذا الشهر الكريم، وهو شهر الله المحرم، وفي هذا المكان الكريم، وهو بيت الله سبحانه وتعالى، أن يرفع الله سبحانه وتعالى الغمة عن الأمة. اللهم ارفع الغمة عن الأمة، اللهم ارفع الغمة عن الأمة، اللهم ردنا إلى دينك ردًا جميلًا، اللهم خذ بنواصينا إليك أخذ الكرام عليك، اللهم أخرجنا من الظلمات إلى النور، ووفقنا لاتباع حبيبنا محمدٍ صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى نسعد بالدنيا ونسعد في الآخرة يا رب العالمين. إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وإن خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها، وإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. تحدثنا عن حب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأمته، فعلمنا علم اليقين أنه صلى الله عليه وسلم يحب أمته ويدعو لها في صلاته صلى الله عليه وسلم، وكان رحيماً بأمته، وكان يشفق على أمته صلى الله عليه وسلم. وعلمنا أننا لابد علينا أن نحبه صلى الله عليه وسلم، فحبنا للنبي عبادة لله سبحانه وتعالى وتقرباً إليه. وعلمنا أيضاً أن الحب لا يأتي باللسان فقط، ولكنه ينبع من القلب بالإيمان عقيدة في محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وباللسان صلاة وسلاما عليه صلى الله عليه وسلم ونشرا لسنته، وبالجوارح عملا يقينيا مستنين بسنته صلى الله عليه وسلم. وعلمنا أن أفضل من أحب النبي هم الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم، وكان حبهم للنبي ظاهراً جلياً في حياتهم. وعلمنا أننا إذا أردنا أن نستن بسنته ونتبع صحابته والتابعين ومن تلا، فلا بد علينا أن نري الله من أنفسنا خيراً، فيكون الحب صادقاً، حبنا لله وحبنا للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. فمن حبنا له صلى الله عليه وسلم كما علمنا اتباعنا لسنته واقتداءنا به والائتمار بالأوامر التي أمر بها والانتهاء عن النواهي التي نهى عنها. ومن أعظم الطرق لنيل محبة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كثرة الصلاة والسلام عليه، فاللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه، اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه كما تحب أن يصلى عليه، اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه عدد من يصلي عليه، اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه عدد من لم يصلي عليه. اللهم إنا نسألك أن نكون من الذين يصلون عليه في الدنيا ويكونون معه يوم القيامة في الجنة في الآخرة يا رب العالمين. My dear beloved brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. It's the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are Muslims. We live until today is a Friday, the best day in the week. This month, the month of Al-Muharram, one of the four sacred months in the year. And we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these specific times, in this specific place, the masjid, the best place, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps the Muslim ummah. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala takes our hands out from the difficulties of this life and the challenges and the darkness of desires, temptations, shaitan traps, to the light of iman and tawheed and following Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have started talking about Sayyidina Muhammad loving his ummah so much. And then in return, we love him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so much by following him. And one of the most effective ways to love him is to say salah and salam upon him a lot, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has many benefits, countless benefits. Al-Imam ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, one of the pillars when we speak about Muslim scholarship, Al-Imam ibn al-Qayyim comes out. He rahimahullah wrote many books, and in one of his books about the benefits of as-salah and as-salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned about 39 benefits. 39 benefits that you get if you continue sending salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We're just going to memorize and just summarize some of them. The first one, we will take the ayah in Surah Al-Ahzab when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك عليه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His angels are sending salah upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. O who you believe, send salah upon him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this ayah will teach us lots of benefits when we say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, or Allah, when we say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when his name sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned, and how effective this salah will be in our lives, and how helpful it will be for us in this dunya and in akhirah. The first benefit that we get when we say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, or we say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when we hear his name sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, imtithalan li amri Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Faqad amarana Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fi Qur'anihi an nusalli alayhi faqal, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Bisighatil amr, amarana rabbuna, وهو الواحد سبحانه وتعالى الذي نعبده ونمجده أن نصلي على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. فمن لم يصلي عليه صلى الله عليه وسلم فقد ترك أمر الله فسوف يكون من العصاة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding us in this ayah So when we say salah and salam upon the Prophet, we are obeying the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he says, oh, believe, send salah and salam upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وفي الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم توافقا لصلاة الله سبحانه وتعالى عليه ولصلاة الملائكة عليه. فالصلاة من الله رحمة، والصلاة من الملائكة طلب استغفار، والصلاة من المؤمنين دعاء. When we send salah and salam upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, we coincide, we go with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending salah upon him. And the salah of Allah is rahmah, mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also it will coincide with the angels sending salah upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the salah from angels, a request submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for maghfirah to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we as believers will be sending salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and our salah for him is a dua that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will get the unique status that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him in dunya, will get a unique status in the akhirah, as he told us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. عَسَى أَن يَبْعَثَكَ رَبُّكَ مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا. When we send salah and salam upon the Prophet, we ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him this unique status on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, and we will be included in his shafa'a if we do so, inshallah. And we will explain this later. So first, we go with the commandment of Allah. We go with the salah of Allah upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is rahmah. Third, we will coincide with the salah of the angels upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is a request of maghfirah. And then we will earn the salah from Allah upon us. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu said, when this ayah in Surah Al-Ahzab was revealed, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima, and before that, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi, Allah and his angels, they send salah upon the Prophet. Then the Sahaba said, oh Messenger of Allah, this is for you. Allah is giving you a unique status in this ayah. What about us, the believers, those who love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in another ayah, as Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas said, هُوَ الَّذِي يُصَلِّي عَلَيْكُمْ وَمَلَائِكَتُهُ لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayah that says, he subhanahu wa ta'ala send salah upon you, believers, Muslims, and his angels send salah upon you too, to take you out of the darkness to the light. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala is all forgiving and all merciful to the believers. So this is from rahmatullahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we continue to remember him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and send salah upon him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what else we get if we continue doing so? If we remember the last time, we remember the hadith of Sayyidina Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu, in which he was asking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how much you want me to specify from my time to give salah and salam upon you? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, if the quarter it will be good, but if you increase it will be bitter. Then he said half, then he said two thirds, then he said I will do all my time of dua, salah and salam upon you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him and gave him the glad news, إِذَن تُكْفَى هَمُّكَ وَيُغْفَرْ ذَنْبُكَ. Your affairs will be taken care of and your sins will be forgiven. These are two benefits of continuing salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Your affairs will be taken care of because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named himself al-wakil, the most that you can trust. When you say la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, there is no power, there is no mightiness except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you take off any power, you take off anything that may signify your power or mightiness, and you give it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He is the real powerful subhanahu wa ta'ala, the almighty, the all exalted subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you send salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of your affairs. He will plan for you, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala will dispose your affairs in a manner that will amaze you. And this is the way of the believers. And after that, your sins will be completely erased and forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What else do we need? Nothing. If our affairs are taken care by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself, He's the one who is helping me in my house with my wife and children. He's the one who's taking care of my affairs in my job. No one can harm me except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one can benefit me except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I lose something, I say alhamdulillah, something better is coming on the way. If something happens in my life which causes me negativity, I take it as a source of positivity, and I come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I say alhamdulillah, because I know He's al-wakil. He's the one who takes care of the affairs, and I trust Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I believe that whatever in His hand, it will come to me before whatever I have in my own hand. This is the real Muslim, the real believer, when he or she says, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of the benefits when we send salah and salam and upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أننا نتجنب أن نكون من البخلاء، لأن الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم قال في الحديث الذي يرويه لنا سيدنا علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه وكرم الله وجهه، والحديث رواه الإمام الترمذي وحسنه وقال حديث حسن صحيح، بأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: البخيل من ذكرت عنده فلم يصلي عليه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله. One benefit when we say اللهم صل على محمد, that we will be away from بخل, شح. That this characteristic will take people away from رحمة الله سبحانه وتعالى. To be among those who like to keep things, not to give them in the way of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So if we withhold things and wealth, and we don't give it out, this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like. And if we do not send salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we'll be in the same place with those who do not want to give. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us, the bakhil, the miser, the one who doesn't want to give, is the one that my name is mentioned in front of him or her, and they do not send salah and salam upon me. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So brothers and sisters, if we keep counting the benefits of salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it will take long time. But what we take from that is that sending salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is one of our pillars of our aqidah. Some of the ulama said it is an obligation, although some others said it is sunnah, mustahab. But most of the ulama said it is an obligation to send salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded the believers to do so in the Quran, and Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encouraged the Sahaba and the Muslims to do so when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man salla alayya salatan sallallahu biha alayhi ashra aw ashra salawat wa كفر عنه بها عشر خطيئات ورفعه الله بها عشر درجات. Those who send salah and salam upon the Prophet one time, they will get 10 حسنات from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase for them 10 سيئات. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase and raise. He will raise their level. He will elevate them, subhanahu wa ta'ala, 10 times in Jannatullah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all what we talk about now, it is almost all regarding the dunya, that we get the salah, we get the maghfirah, and also those who send salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will get hidayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and al-qalb sawfa yakunu hayyan bi dhikrillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we look to the ayah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu istajibu lillahi wa lirrasooli إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم واعلموا أن الله يحول بين المرء وقلبه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in this ayah, O believers, respond to Allah and His Messenger when He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam calls you to whatever gives you life. Whatever gives us life is the Quran, is the Sunnah, is following Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We will get a live heart, a heart that will have the pulse of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, the heart that is connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the heart that is not heedless, that is always remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will be among those who remember Allah a lot. Alladhina amanu wa tatma'innu qulubuhum bidhikrillah, ala bidhikrillahi تطمئن القلوب. فاللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه كما يحب أن يصلى عليه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه عدد من صلى عليه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه عدد من لم يصلي عليه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه كما يحب ربنا أن يصلى عليه. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وحبيبه وبعد. صلاة and سلام upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has an amazing influence upon our lives, and it will direct us إن شاء الله تعالى to the way of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم in dunya and akhirah. A few benefits from the salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the akhirah. One of them, and it is the most important one, that we will be included in shafa'at al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this clearly in the hadith in Sahih al-Imam al-Tirmidhi rahimahullah, in awla al-nasi bi yawm al-qiyamati aktharuhum alayya salah. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه. The most people among the Muslims who will have rights to be with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah are the most ones who send salah and salam upon him. Just imagine coming to the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, the sun is closed from everyone, people are scared. If you read the ayat of the description of Yawm al-Qiyamah, and you understand the meaning, you will just forget everything else. And at that time, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be interceding for you and me. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be asking for maghfirah and rahmah for the sinners of this ummah, the disobedience of this ummah, those who have seen the way of Allah, yet they followed the shaitan. But they have La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah in their hearts, and they come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in tawbah. So inclusion in the shafa'at al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a big part of the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will only give it to those not just send salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by tongue, but they meant what they have said. When they said, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, so Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was their example. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was their messenger. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was their mentor, the one whom they follow, the one whom they love more than anything else. Then the inclusion in the shafa'at al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be a must for those who followed and repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers and sisters, Shafa'atul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is one of the things that if you think about it, it is part that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing us His rahmah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we knew that He created rahmah 100 parts and He only sent one part to this dunya and He kept 99 parts for that day, the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. From these parts of rahmah will be Shafa'atul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the shafa'ah will be for those who are eligible for shafa'ah. Those that their aqeedah, their creed, their faith is correct. They worship only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They do not worship the dollar. They do not worship the houses. They do not worship the cars. They do not worship the desires and temptations. They do not worship this dunya. Although they had many ways to deviate, but they preferred the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to any other way. Those who will be eligible for his shafa'ah, the ones who love him most sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the love has to come from the heart, as we said before, expressed by the tongue and followed by actions. And love for Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has to have a proof, not just saying. As the poet was saying, تَعْصِ الْإِلَهَ وَأَنْتَ تَزْعُمُ حُبَّهُ هَذَا لَعَمْرِي فِي الْقِيَاسِ بَدِيعُ لَوْ كُنْتَ تَصْدُقُ حُبَّهُ لَأَطَعْتَهُ إِنَّ الْمُحِبَّ لِمَنْ يُحِبُّ مُطِيعُ. If you really love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will not disobey Him. Because those who love, they always follow those whom they love. We say we love Allah. Do we follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do we put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first in our lives? When our brothers and sisters in Karachi, Pakistan, they are swimming and drowning in floods, and they are looking for something to eat, for a shelter to stay, for a hand to be stretched out with goodness, righteousness, and sadaqah, are we going to help? When we say we love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we see part of Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this part of the world, one of our beloved countries, the country of Pakistan, and they are suffering, and we see the news, unfortunately, and we forget. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, this makes us like think about our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we see these things happening everywhere, Lebanon, Gaza, Syria, and Libya, and Yemen, and then coming to Sudan, and then coming to Pakistan, and we shouldn't be sad, because this is wa'adullah. This is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is sunnatullah. And there is no change for sunnatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muslims, wherever they are, they will be tested with calamities, with shortages of death or of lives, shortages of fruits, and many other things. But those who are patient will be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we stood up for our brothers and sisters in Beirut a couple of weeks ago, we have to stand again with our brothers and sisters today in Karachi, Pakistan. And next week we will stand for another cause, maybe in Sudan. And the week after we will stand for another brother or another sister in need, because this is our life. If we do this, our life is meaningful. If we do this, we live in ibadah. If we do this, we live in Jannah of dunya. Getting together. We all hope that the Muslim Ummah will get united. But some of us never do anything for that cause. We say, I wish I see the Muslim Ummah one body, as it was in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Khulafa, against all the fitan, all the enemies, all the haters. We come and we stand as one. How can we achieve this when we are living here in a luxurious life and we are forgetting our brothers and sisters who are suffering? So our love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to be manifested today, brothers and sisters. Our love for Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he said, Al-mu'minu akhul mu'min, The believer is a brother to a believer. He did not say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, an Arab is a brother to an Arab, or an Arab is a brother to an Arab. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, mu'min and Muslim, wherever you are, you should be connected. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, told us, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَادِّهِمْ وَتَرَاحُمِهِمْ وَتَعَاطُفِهِمْ كَمَثَلِ الْجَسَدِ الْوَاحِدِ إِذَا اشْتَكَى مِنْهُ عُضْوٌ تَدَاعَى لَهُ سَائِرُ الْجَسَدِ بِالسَّهَرِ وَالْحُمَّى. We look like one body. If one part is sick, the whole body is in an emergency state. And today, our brothers and sisters in Karachi, Pakistan, they are calling for us. They want our help. They want us to show them that we care. It doesn't matter how much we collect. It doesn't matter how much you give. Wallahi, brothers, sisters, one single dollar on the day of Friday, the month of Al-Muharram, inside the masjid, can take me and you to Jannatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala and maghfiratullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and 60, 70 years of a'mal may not take me to Jannah. Just $1 given sincerely to that cause. A brother that we never saw, a sister that we never met, but we just give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We just give because we love them, because they are our brothers and sisters in Islam. This is the solidarity that Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught his sahaba. And they conveyed the message, and they gave the legacy, and they left it behind. And we are trying to pick up some of their a'mal, and we are trying to reach, and it is between us and them, it's too far. But we will take the love of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as our means. As Sayyidina Anas radiallahu anhu was there when a man walked to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asked, O Messenger of Allah, when is the hour? Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what did you do for the hour? What did you prepare for the hour? He said, I didn't prepare much. I only love Allah and love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-mar'u ma'a man ahab. You will be with those whom you love. Sayyidina Anas radiallahu anhu said, we did not become happy and pleased with anything before that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the man or the woman will be with those whom he loves. And Anas said, I make Allah witness, I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr and Umar, but my a'mal are not like their a'mal, but I wish to be with them. This is the love that we should have, brothers and sisters. And inshallah ta'ala, today's collection will go to our brothers and sisters in Pakistan, Karachi. So when you are walking out, please give anything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you back health, wealth, and he subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless for you your wealth and your family and your spouses. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala today that he subhanahu wa ta'ala uplifts the calamity on the shoulders of Ummat Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help our brothers and sisters in need in Karachi, Pakistan, and in Sudan, and in Lebanon, and all around the world. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala his rahmah, his maghfirah, his jannah. Allahumma aghfir lana ma qaddamna wa ma akharna, ma asrarna wa ma a'lanna, ma anta a'lamu bihi minna, tal muqaddim wa antal muakhir wa anta ala kulli shay'in qadir. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان إيتاء ذي القربى ينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم أذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أجل وأكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقموا الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله